Our devotion is taken from Matthew chapter 7, verses 1 to 5. Matthew 7, 1 to 5. It is indeed a blessing to be here again this morning. Thank God for traveling mercies and for all of his favor. God is good. He is great. He is awesome. And I just want to give him thanks this morning. Let us pray. Father God, I bless your name this morning. I worship you. I honor you. I adore you. All the glory belongs to you, God, because you are worthy of it all. And I bless your holy name. Thank you, Lord, for this opportunity to bring a word to us again this morning. Lord God, I pray that it would touch some heart this morning and bring about change. Bless us, Father God, here at ZJoyVI Radio. Continue to keep us, uphold us, Lord. Continue, Lord God, to use your servant for your honor and for your glory. We bless your name this morning, Father. Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. Matthew chapter 7, verses 1 to 5. I'm reading from the New King James Version. The title of the devotion is Judge Not. Matthew 7, 1 to 5. Judge not that you be not judged. For with what judgment you judge, you will be judged. And with the measure you use, it will be measured back to you. And why do you look at the speck in your brother's eye, but do not consider the plank in your own eye? Or how can you say to your brother, let me remove the speck from your eye, and look, a plank is in your own eye? Hypocrite. First remove the plank from your own eye, and then you will see clearly to remove the speck from your brother's eye. Matthew 7, 1 to 5. Lord, pierce our hearts and challenge our lives as we meditate on your word. Help us to see ourselves and not judge others. Let me read Matthew 7, verses 1 to 5 from the Message version. This one hits right in the chest. Reading from verse 1, don't pick on people, jump on their failures, criticize their faults, unless, of course, you want the same treatment. That critical spirit has a way of boomeranging. It's easy to see a smudge on your neighbor's face and be oblivious to the ugly sneer on your own. Do you have the nerve to say, let me wash your face? When your own face is distorted with contempt, is this whole traveling road show mentality all over again, playing a holier than thou part instead of just living your part? Wipe that ugly snare off your own face, and you might be fit to offer a washcloth to your neighbor. After reading that in the Message version, all I could say is, wow, wow, wow. This verse actually tells us that we are not to judge the motives of others and then render our own verdict. Sometimes we use ourselves as the standard of judgment, but we must be very careful, for with what measure you meet, you shall be judged. The words that you be not judged refer to the ultimate judgment of God rather than our own judgment. We cannot, even if we wanted to, be someone else's judge. Jesus is the final judge, and each person shall stand before him in judgment. A mote is a small speck of sawdust. We know how small that is. But a beam is like a rafter used in a building. So the idea of this text is that I cannot remove the speck or the mote from my brother's eye until I have removed the rafter from my own eye. Because if the rafter is in my eye, I can see clearly to remove the speck on your face. In John chapter 8, the religious people of the day brought a woman who was caught in the very act of adultery to Jesus to be stoned to death. Jesus turned the tables on them. He told them, anyone that is without sin, cast the first stone. Not one of them could cast a stone at her. Jesus' words made them conscious of their own imperfections and sins, and they all walked away. You see, we do not look at our imperfections. We do not look at the things that we are doing. We're just looking at other people and judging their actions based on the standard that we have set in our minds. Jesus told the woman that he did not come to condemn her and to go and sin no more. In the book of Luke chapter 7, the woman who anointed Jesus' feet in Bethany was judged because of her known sinful lifestyle. However, she was accepted by Jesus to anoint his feet. She was accepted in his presence, hallelujah, even as those present judged her and judged Jesus as well. He accepted her in his presence. You may be in a place where people are standing judging you, and God accepts you, hallelujah, into his presence. Glory to God. You are in the presence of God, but they are judging you. Jesus did not rebuke the woman, but he reprimanded Simon, who had him in his house, who had brought him to his house. As a matter of fact, the person they were judging was the one who Jesus ministered to. Let's think about that. The person they were judging was the one that Jesus ministered to. He didn't minister to Simon. He didn't minister to those who were judging this woman. He ministered to the woman herself. She ministered to him. Glory to God. She ministered to him in her sinful state. And he, in turn, transformed her life in the midst of those who scorned her. Psalm 23 verse 5 says, "You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies." Instead of focusing on her sin, Jesus honored her in the presence of her enemies by granting her forgiveness. The scripture we read says, "Do you have the nerve to say, 'Let me wash your face for you,' when your own face is distorted in contempt?" My God, before we look at the sin of others, we must check ourselves and make sure that our motives are pure. Judge not, that you be not judged. The Message translation says, "Don't pick on people, jump on their failures, criticize their faults, unless, of course, you want the same treatment." When we consider the sins of others, we are often quick to judge them, but we are reluctant to forgive. However, God's word teaches us the opposite. Jesus gives us several examples of Christ-like responses to sin. Before we judge others, let us question ourselves. Excuse me. Before we judge others, let us question ourselves. One, am I willing to be judged in the same way that I am judging others? Matthew 7 and 2 says, "For with the judgment that you judge, you will be judged. And with the measure you use, it will be measured back to you." Number two, am I willing to place stumbling blocks in the path of others? Romans 14, 13. "Therefore, let us not judge one another anymore, but rather resolve this, not to put a stumbling block or a cause to fail, a cause to fall in our brother's way." Number three, am I willing to forgive others so that I will be forgiven? Matthew 6, 14 to 15. "For if you forgive men their trespasses, your heavenly Father will also forgive you. But if you do not forgive men their trespasses, neither will your Father forgive your trespasses." But Pastor, I don't have any trespasses to forgive. Check yourself. "But if you do not forgive men their trespasses, neither will your Father forgive your trespasses." Every day, we have to ask God to forgive us for something. And if you are walking in unforgiveness, the scripture is plain before us. Neither will your Father forgive your trespasses. This is serious business. Number four, am I willing to show my love for God by being kind and forgiving to others? Colossians 3:12-13. Therefore, as the elect of God, holy and beloved, put on tender mercies, kindness, humility, meekness, long-suffering, bearing with one another, and forgiving one another. If anyone has a complaint against another, even as Christ forgave you, so you also must do. Sometimes I wonder if we read the Bible in the right way, because the Bible is so straightforward. Even as Christ forgave us, so we also must do. Jesus teaches us how to demonstrate forgiveness and love to not only our brothers and our sisters, but to sinners and even to those who have wronged us, criticized us, and judged us. We must still forgive. Judge not that you be not judged. Our prayer today, Father God, help us to be kind and tender-hearted toward others. Give us spiritual eyes to see past their struggles, wisdom to pursue their recovery, courage to offer help, and help us to walk in forgiveness, even as you expect us to follow in your footsteps. In Jesus' name, amen. Father God, we thank you this morning. We thank you for the upcoming week, Lord God, and we thank you, Father, that you, Lord God, will keep, Father. You, Lord God, will be in all the preparations, Lord. You will be, Lord, in all the different activities, Father, that your name alone will be exalted in the midst of every celebration, God. We pray a covering over Evangelist Burns and over the rest of the team, Lord, the planning committee. Father, we thank you and we praise you for them. We thank you, Lord God, for guidance in every activity. We thank you for protection in every activity on the sea, Lord God. We ask for your protection, Lord. We ask for your covering, God. On the land, Father, we ask for your protection. We ask for your covering, God. Father, let your angels surround and keep them. And Lord God, let your name be glorified in the midst of everything. In Jesus' mighty name, be with all those that are traveling, Father, traveling mercies for everyone. Favor, Lord God, in the name of Jesus. We bless your name, God, and we thank you for what you are about to do through ZJoyVI family. In Jesus' name, amen.